Hello there friends, Ken here, and welcome to Stardew Valley. Now I've seen a lot of people talking about this game, I've watched a little bit of it in action, and I wanted to give it a shot for myself. So let's just hop right in here with a brand new game. If you haven't seen this before, it's kind of a little bit Harvest Moon, a little bit Animal Crossing, but also its own kind of thing, made by one guy. So, very interesting stuff. Now, let's make our character. Be a man, we can be a lady. Be a man, why not? So, have a look at our options here. Plenty of different skin colours you can go down. Oof, you can get real weird, look at this. Very colourful. What do we fancy? Sort of a belly. Maybe a bit too pink. How about that one? That's quite a nice... Have a look at the hair colours. We go for quite a rad kind of pinkish or a bluish if we like. What about that? Very fancy. Hair. Have a look at our options here. Plenty of options. I wonder how far through it goes. 15, 16. Look at all these hairstyles, crikey. Plenty of customization options. 32 different ones. Pretty cool, quite like that. Quite good fun. Or we could go for like the Final Fantasy style hair. Too many options, I'm terrible at making decisions. You go for longer hair, we fancy. Might just go for this kind of sweep here. Nothing too weird. I think there's a lot of shirts. 112 shirts. Ooh, the skull. Pretty funky. It's like a little skeleton motif there as well. Quite like that. That nice jacket. And accessories, we could have a beard. Moustache. Have that kind of goatee. I quite like that goatee, the blue goatee. It's quite good fun. What about our eye colour? Blue to match our... It's maybe a little bit weird if our eyes are also blue. Go with our hair. Is that weird? I don't know. What about if we change our hair a little bit? We made it like a... more of a greenish kind of hue. That maybe works a little bit better. Cats or dogs? I quite like a cat. They can look after themselves. I like dogs as well, but I think we'll go with cats for now. We'll make our things a little bit darker if we want. Go for the darker pants. I like that kind of hue. And, okay, name. Ken. Let's go with Ken. Farm name. Well, plenty of potential options here. We could go with a simple Ken's farm. We could go with Grand Farm. Or the Cheeky Farm. Or Big Old Farm. Apple Farm. We could go with something clever like Server Farm, you know, be a little bit witty about it. I'd like something alliterative, something beginning with F. Like a Fragrant Farm or Fun Time Farm. Or Falafel Farm. Good old Ponder. What about our favourite thing? What's our... Maybe we'll come back to the farm in a second. What's our favourite thing? My favourite thing is music. There we go. That's quite vague, but I like that. Farm name. Gosh, this is a more difficult decision than I'd anticipated. What does this set up the top do? Oh, we can rotate our character. Pretty cool look. The fam farm. We'll go with the Y2 farm. Gosh, I'm very stumped on farm names. I'm gonna go with a funhouse farm. And we wanna skip the intro? No, we wanna see the intro. Right, let's begin. An old gent lying in bed by the fire. And for my very special grandson, I want you to have this sealed envelope. Oh, thank you very much. No, don't open it yet. Have patience. Now listen close. There will come a day when you feel crushed by the burden of modern life. And your bright spirit will fade before a growing emptiness. Crikey, grandfather, that's a little bit dreary. When that happens, my boy, you'll be ready for this gift. Well, I guess we'll keep it in our pocket for now. Now let Grandpa rest. XX years later. That's supposed to be 20 years? And here, Jojo. Oh, the work light's on. We've got to thrive. We've got to work hard. Oh, look at this. Cubicles. Smile, you're with Jojo. Oh, that one's been terminated. This guy's got a cheeky hat. He's like a cowboy. He's just licking his lips over and over. Oh, and there's us. Oh, we look a bit down, got our eyes closed. Well, we've had enough. We're tired. We're stressed out. Life's not better with Jojo. We're not having fun at all. But what's in our drawer? A mysterious letter. From Grandfather. You know what? It's time. We're feeling overburdened. Let's crack the letter. Dear Ken, if you're reading this, you must be in dire need of a change. The same thing happened to me long ago. I lost sight of what mattered most in life, real connections with other people and nature. Though I dropped everything and moved to the place I truly belong. I've enclosed the deed to that place, my pride and joy. Fun House Farm. It's located in Stardew Valley on the southern coast. It's the perfect place to start your new life. This was my most precious gift of all, and now it's yours. I know you'll honour the family name, my boy. Good luck. Love, Grandpa. Oh, and I hope you didn't wait too long to open this, because it'll probably be a bit overrun. P.S. If Lewis is still alive, say hi to the old guy for me, will ya? There we are. A deed. To Funhouse Farm. Well, we should probably head over there and see what it's like, I guess. Here we are on the bus. Travelling through the hills and dales. Very peaceful, really. Quite relaxed. Half a mile to Stardew Valley. I wonder what awaits us. What adventures lie in store. Oh! Hello, you must be Ken. Hello, Robin. I'm Robin, the local carpenter. Mayor Lewis sent me here to fetch you and show you the way to your new home. He's there right now, tidying things up for your arrival. The farm's right over here if you'll follow me.
Well, Robin, I suppose we will.
Man, look at this place. This is Funhouse Farm.
It does look a little bit run down.
Oh no!
Freaking out.
What's the matter? Sure, it's a bit overgrown, but there's some good soil underneath that mess.
Thanks, it's not a nice thing to say about someone. Oh, you mean you're talking about the land, I see.
With a little dedication, you'll have it cleaned up in no time.
Thanks, Robin. I appreciate your faith in our abilities as a new farmer.
And here we are, your new home.
Ah, the new farmer.
Oh, there he is, there's Lewis.
Welcome, I'm Lewis, mayor of Pelican Town. You know, everyone's been asking about you. It's not every day that someone new moves in. It's quite a big deal. So, you're moving into your grandfather's old cottage. It's a good house, very rustic.
Yeah, you mean it's old-fashioned. That's all you're saying. Outdated. Rustic? That's one way to put it. And her voice has changed completely. Crusty might be a little more apt, though.
Rude!
Lewis is not happy. He just looks like a more realistic take on Luigi, to be honest. Got the green thing and the moustache and the hat.
Don't listen to her again. She's just trying to make you dissatisfied so that you buy one of her house upgrades.
Oh, because she's a carpenter.
Hmm. Anyway, you must be tired from the long journey. You should get some rest.
That is a good idea.
Tomorrow, you ought to explore the town a bit and introduce yourself. The townspeople would appreciate that.
Well, we'll do that, Mayor Lewis.
Oh, I almost forgot. If you have anything to sell, just place it in this box here. I'll come by during the night to collect it.
It's not weird at all. Just, just come up to your house in the night and take stuff out of your box.
Well,
good luck. Thanks, Lewis. Off he goes. Thanks, Robin. See you later. Oh, and the cock crows. Our progress has been saved. Oh, we're in bed. Here we go. Move. Run. Check. Oh, so that's actually the walk button. That's interesting. Parsnip seeds. 15 parsnip seeds. You received 15 parsnip seeds.
Here's a little something to get you started.
Mayor Lewis. Thanks, Lewis. Now, how do we look at our journal? Have a look. What have we got? Map, social, skills, inventory, crafting, collections, options. I don't want to exit game. How do we see our journal? Here we go, F. If you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on the tilled soil to sow a crop. Water every day until the crop's ready to harvest. Cultivate and harvest a parsnip. And our other one? It would be a nice gesture to introduce yourself around town. Some people might be anxious to meet the new farmer. We've greeted 2 of 28 people in the town. Okay, well let's get outside then. Sounds like we've got a lot to do. Anything in here? You don't have any mail. Okay. Well, should we just get to it? Should we start clearing things out a bit? Maybe we should start growing some parsnips. What have we got? Axe to chop wood, hoe to dig and till soil, watering can, pickaxe for stones, and a scythe to cut grass into hay. if you've built a silo. It takes 4 days for parsnips to mature. You can plant them in the spring. I don't know if that's indicated by this here, perhaps. Maybe it is. It's 7:20. Right, we should get to it. Looks like we have 270 energy, full energy. So, bam. Bam. Right, we'll clear out an area first and foremost. What's our... I guess we should cut grass with a scythe, right? That works pretty well. I presume we can't make hay because we don't have a silo. But we can get rid of all this. And we get some fiber, raw material. I like how the trees kind of bop out of the way. Are these like little trees here? And you should, I like how you can shake them as well. Shake the tree. Let's bring this big tree down already. Crack! No messing about there. Oh, I've got the wrong tool out. I think you can collect with any tool, really. It doesn't seem to matter too much what you're using. We'll use the axe to chop this. And this. I wonder if that tree will regrow if we leave the stump down. Maybe it will. Well, we'll probably set up just here for now. We've already used a little chunk of our energy. We don't want to overdo it for now. So we use a hoe to dig and till soil. I presume we can just do this wherever. There we go. We've got 15 seeds. So that's like a 3x5, I suppose. Oh, doesn't actually go right in front of you. Or it does, but you have to move to do it that way. There we go. Right, parsnip seeds. There we go, let's plant them down. No messing around. I need to get a little bit closer. And there we are. And then, I suppose we can water them. I wonder if where we have to go to fill up our water. I wonder if there's a nearby tank or a reservoir. This is very relaxing so far. Just planting some parsnips. Lovely stuff. Right, well, that's that done. I suppose we can get everything else done. Mixed seed, plant them and see what grows. We've got some sap, wood, clay. Crikey, well, we've got like a bunch of stuff I guess we can probably do stuff with eventually. Or we can put it in this box and sell it to Lewis. I suppose we could put this in here. Number 9. Pop it in there. Water it. There we go. We'll see what grows there. Could be anything. Alright, let's go for a walk. We're already halfway down on our energy. Bus stop, Pelican Town. Well, we came from the bus stop. Let's go to Pelican Town. We've got this dandelion. Well, you can see we're pretty full on inventory. So we're going to have to make sure that we deposit some stuff. Don't carry too much around. Just wander through here. See where this leads us. To this big square. Ooh, a hospital. Notices. I want to interact with this. Doesn't seem to do anything right now. Well, let's go in here and see what... So this is the hospital area, I guess. Looks like no one's in. Well, let's just leave for now. no sense in sticking around in there. Oh, so this is like a little store. Hello, sir. Welcome to Pierre's. Need some supplies? So he can sell us some bean starter. Takes 10 days to mature, but keeps producing. Yields multiple beans per harvest. 12 days to produce a large cauliflower. So it takes a little bit longer than the parsnips, but obviously you're gonna end up probably getting more value out of your cauliflower. Tulips you can plant in the spring. Jazz seeds, you know, gonna grow some jazz. Okay, so plenty of options here. We can buy stuff. We've got 500 gold. I suppose we don't need to come here straight away. We can come and buy some seeds when we need them. So let's have a chat to this person. Abigail.
Oh, that's right. I heard someone new was moving on to that old farm.
Is that all she's got to say for now?
It's kind of a shame, really. I've always enjoyed exploring those overgrown fields by myself.
Well, you're still welcome to come by, Abigail. Looks like she doesn't have anything else to say for now. Oh, Leah.
Hello. It's nice to meet you.
Is that all she's got to say?
You picked a good time to move here. The spring is lovely.
It is rather nice, and it's probably a good time to start growing a farm. And here, Caroline.
Hello, you must be Ken, the new farmer. I'm Caroline.
Hello, Caroline. Lovely to meet you.
My husband runs the general store here. And have you met my daughter, Abigail? She's the pale one with the purple hair.
Oh, we did meet Abigail. Don't know why she's like a Texan or something. When you're clearly from like south of England somewhere. We could just go back into his house. That's probably impolite. Well, we'll leave it at that for now. Let's go and have another wander around, see who we can find. How many people have we met so far? 5 of 28. The Star Drop Saloon. Oh, didn't mean to go back outside. Look at the size of this bear over here. Hello.
What'll you have? Hungry, thirsty, I've got just the thing.
Doesn't seem to have too much to say to us though. I wonder if that counts as a person. Apparently not. Or we weren't able to greet him perhaps because he was busily doing stuff. It's 2:10 in the afternoon. There's an arcade here. There's the kind of storage room. Probably shouldn't go back there. There's a Coke machine. Beep. Buy a Joja Cola for 75G. No. Oh, I did. I pushed the wrong button. Well, we bought a cola. Okay, well, that's in our inventory now, I guess. It does give us energy and health. There's a skull-shaped keyhole. A little bit sinister. Journey of the Prairie King. Oh, I see. There's like a little twin-stick shooter. It's quite good fun. Oh no, I'm dead. I'm dead already. I'm not very good at twin-stick shooters, to be honest. So we'll see how this goes. Bang, bang, bang. It's quite a fun little mini game to have. Wonder what this thing does. Oh, it blows everyone up. Very snazzy. We get a coin. Oh no. I'm down again. One life left, it looks like. Oh, we can use space for our item. Oh, so that's like a machine gun. Fantastic. I'll take everyone out. Get another coin. And I see the time running down along the top. That's quite good fun. I don't want to spend too much time with this though. We've only just got it. We've probably got better things to be doing than spending our time on this. And it looks like we've been defeated anyway. Well, we've got one more life, but I think we'll call it at that for now. Don't want to spend too much time messing around on the arcades. We've got people to meet. We've got a farm to tend to. So let's see who's over here. Just another house, perhaps? Oh, very quiet in here. I wonder where everyone's at. You know, it's 3 in the afternoon. Maybe they're all at work. I wonder if there's somewhere where these people work or if they're all farmers. Oh! Oh, there's Elliot. Look at him.
Ah, the new farmer we've all been expecting. And whose arrival has sparked many a conversation.
I'm Elliot. I live in the little cabin by the beach. Well, this one here. It's a pleasure to meet you.
It's lovely to meet you too, Elliot. Doesn't look like he has anything to say to us right now.
Oh, I can't take this because my inventory is full. But there you are. You see, you gotta keep an eye on what you can carry. Oh no, the bridge is out. With 300 pieces of wood, this could be... That seems like a lot of pieces of wood. We've got 14 so far. So if we had 300, we could fix this and get across there. There you go. Just yet another thing that add to the list of possible things to do. Anyone down on the pier? Oh, there's a house. There's Mayor Lewis. Hello, Lewis.
So, how was your first night in the old cottage?
It was okay.
Your grandpa used to complain about the rickety old bed, but I think deep down he actually loved that house.
Looks like that's all Lewis has got to say to us for now. Gone fishing. I'll be back tomorrow. Well, Lewis was just in there. Is he the fisherman? Is he off fishing now? Bizarre. Anything going on down here? Doesn't look like it. I suppose we can probably fish. Once we've got a rod, can we fill up our watering can? Can be refilled at any water source. There you go, look at that. Filled it right back up. Just nick some water from the beach. I suppose it's not really theft. Free water for everyone. Trying to see what that thing does, but it doesn't appear to do much. Just a little statue. Okay, well, let's keep exploring around. There's Elliot again. And here's our map. So here's the farm, Funhouse Farm. We've actually got quite a large plot of land. Something up there. Harvey's Clinic, Pierre's General Store, the Saloon, home of George, Evelyn and Alex. The Mayor's Manor off to the right. Should we head over there? I suppose that's probably where Lewis went to. Music's very chill as well, very relaxing. Hello!
Hello there.
Welcome to the Stardew Valley Archaeological Office.
Hi, Gunter.
Ha, this is embarrassing, but the previous curator made off with the entire collection. We don't have any artifacts for display, but I'm hoping to remedy that soon. Hey, if you find any artifacts or minerals out there, would you let me know?
Absolutely, Gunter. So this guy... It's, you know, we can bring our artifacts to him. There's a book missing here. But yeah, so I guess we can kind of, if we find anything cool, we can bring it back here. I want to pet this bear. But it won't let me. Yeah, look at this. Very empty. Quite sad, really. Why would you make off with all the artifacts? That's tantamount to thievery. But, not to worry. I'm sure we'll fill that up over time. Let's take a wander up here. The blacksmith, perhaps? Open 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. What's the time now? 6:30. Crikey, we're going to have to get back soon. It's almost time for bed. Time moves pretty quickly, actually. You can see it kind of popping forward. Oh, there's Jojo Mart. Our old employers.
Welcome to Jojo Mart. How are you doing today? I don't believe we've met. I'm Morris, Jojo Customer Satisfaction Representative. When you decide you want to become a Jojo member, I'll be delighted to help make your transition a joyous experience.
Well, I don't know if we want to deal with Jojo too much at the moment. After all, they were the reason we ended up having to come out here. Who's this lady here? Can we talk to her? Well, this is if we want to buy stuff. I just want to talk to the lady, but no, she's busy. She's very intent working on her job. Let's have a look, see where we're at. Oh, we're near the home of George, Evelyn and Alex. I kind of wanted to visit them. Oh, someone else over there. Another mysterious stranger. So this map doesn't show you exactly where you are. It's just like... You're in that sort of section. So now we should be heading over to the section with this house. Hopefully we can find George, Evelyn and Alex, or at least one of them. Say hello. Pelican Town.
It's locked. Oh, this is the community center. Looks like it's kind of shut down, to be honest. A little bit sad. Getting late. I wonder if this is where the house is at. A little bit, so this is where we came before. So this must be the house of those people of locked, open 8 till 8. Oh, we've just missed it. Well, it looks like everything's shutting up for the night, so I suppose we should probably head back home and do the same ourselves. Get a good night's kip. We haven't really eaten anything. I don't know if you have to eat anything or not, to be honest. The game hasn't told us to eat anything yet. It might be one of those things where they don't necessarily show you eating, but if you want to, you can have a snack and that'll stand you in good stead for the next day. Anything on the telly? Weather report. Welcome to Kozu 5, your number one source for weather, news and entertainment. And now the weather forecast for tomorrow. It's going to rain all day tomorrow. I suppose that's good. It probably means we won't have to water our plants. You know what? It's our first day. Should we get an early night? Let's do it. Take a nice rest. And we wake up, fresh and ready, for another day on Funhouse Farm. Oh, we got mail. Advertisement. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Does this sound like you? Well, Pierre's got you covered. Stop by Pierre's General Store today and check out our affordable size 24 backpack. See you soon. Well, it's not raining at all. We were told it would be raining. Well, let's water our plants then. And then we'll head over to Pierre's. Lovely. A big size 24 backpack would certainly stand us in good stead. I like that you can kind of walk on these and it doesn't seem to matter too much. It's not like, I know in Minecraft, you can sort of walk on stuff, but you have to be very careful, or you can sort of disrupt the crops and then they won't grow anymore. Right, well, Pierre's is just over here. Shouldn't take us too long to get there. And then maybe we can get a bit more space in our backpack. Oh, it's not open till 9 a.m. Still only 7:20. But what are we going to do with our morning? Maybe we should head back to the farm and start clearing the place up a little bit. I suppose we could sell like this dandelion or something. It's weird that it moves up and down depending on where you're at on the screen. The leaves make a good salad. You could eat the dandelion. For energy and health. I wonder how you eat it. Eat this dandelion. Yes! Aha! Look at that energy we've got. Not showing our health. I imagine that's because we're not in a situation where health's a concern. But I know this game does have sort of caves you can go into and you have to deal with creatures and monsters and such in the cave. We got a geode. You found a geode. The local blacksmith can break it open for you. Who knows what might be hidden inside. Oh, very nice. Where's our axe? And then back to the pickaxe to break the rocks. Okay. Oh, and they've dropped something on the floor that we can't pick up. Maybe we can sell something out of here. Can we sell this clay, maybe? Oh, you can just chuck it in. That's pretty useful, actually. So you can see the last item shipped. So I guess you can save the last item you shipped if you want to get it back. We don't want to get it back. We're happy to sell that clay, that one clay. You can always get more later. Ooh. Hello there. Just got back from a fishing trip. You should come down to the beach sometime. I've got something for you, Willie. Thanks, Willie. We'll head down to the beach sometime and check out what Willie's got for us. Okay, over we go. This is incredibly pleasant. So maybe if you want to see some more of this, do let me know. Because I'm definitely going to play a decent bunch of it. If you'd like to see, you know, just a regular check-in, let me know. Or if you want to do like more of a series, then I'd be interested in doing that. Hello, Pierre. Hello, Pierre. Where's his... Right, so he said he's got a backpack. Is that in here somewhere? I don't immediately see it. Where's your backpack, Pierre? Maybe that's in a different section. Backpack upgrade, 2000G? We don't have 2000G. Oh no. Well, now I'm sad. On that backpack. Ah, well. I suppose if we can't have it, we can't have it. We go back into his house. Shall wear something special at the aerobics meet up today? Why are you in my house? What are you doing here? Get out. Oh, look. Like a... Maybe an NES or something? Maybe a little bit bigger than that. That sort of thing, though. Like a classic games console. I like the look of it. Ooh, who's this? Oh. You aren't exactly how I imagined, but that's okay. I'm Jody. Hi, Jody. It's quite a little town, so it's very exciting when someone new moves in. Having a farmer around could really change things. We haven't had any farmers. Good morning, Jody. Who's this? Emily. Oh, I can read it on your face. You're going to love it here in Pelican Town. If you're ever looking for something to do in the evening, stop by the saloon. That's where I work. Will do, Emily. Oh, and who's this?
Ah, Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie.
I know there's a lot of sort of West Country, but I suppose that's probably appropriate. It's also an easy accent for me to do.
I sell livestock and animal care products at my ranch. You should swing by sometime.
This house here with the sun on it. Ooh. Hello. Haley.
Oh, you're that new farmer boy, aren't you?
I am indeed.
Oh, I'm Haley. If it weren't for those horrendous clothes, you might actually be cute.
Okay, Haley. That's very nice of you to say. A bit of a backhanded compliment there. We're going to explore her house. She's left. You're not good enough friends with Haley to enter her bedroom. Sounds about right, to be honest. That's probably fair. She's already left us alone in her house. Oh, and this is Emily's room, so Haley and Emily live here. Okay. That's good to know. And then over here, someone else's house. Looks like. Oh, check out this rockin' dude on his guitar. You're not good enough friends with Sam to enter his bed. He's in there. Can't we just go in and say hi? I suppose not. Alright, well, we'll leave Sam to his jamming. Oh, he's got everything in there. He's got a keyboard, a guitar, all the amenities. Sewer! We use the sewer. It's locked. Probably wise, to be honest. Don't want to let the new kid in town mess around with the sewer. I like how we can shake the bush. Look like someone went behind that bush. But, we'll leave them to their doings. Oh!
Ahoy there, son. Heard there was a newcomer in town. Good to finally meet ya.
Oh, this is Willy. I probably should use Willy's voice, rather.
Ah,
I'm still trying to unwind from a month out on the salty seas. Sorry, I got caught up. I got caught up in my pirate accent. It was a big haul. I sold a lot of good fish. Finally saved enough to buy me a new rod. Here, I want you to have my old fishing rod. It's important to me that the art of fishing stays alive, and hey, maybe you'll buy something from the shop once in a while. Well, not now you've taught us to fish. Now we don't need to buy anything from the shop. Or maybe he sells fishing goods and stuff. The first hit's free, and then he's like, oh, now you've got to buy some bait. Like razor blades, they give you the actual razor cheap, and then the blades cost a fortune. We got a bamboo pole. There's good water here in the valley. All kinds of fish. Oh yeah, my shop's back open now, so come by if you need supplies. I'll also buy anything you catch. If it smells, it sells. What my old pappy used to say anyway. Weird, I was told that when stuff smells, it's not as fresh anymore. But, hey, who's to judge, eh? Oh, he's disappeared. A weird ghost fisherman. Should we have a look in his shop? Trout soup. Pretty salty. And a bamboo pole, in case we lose our first one, I suppose. Fantastic. Well, we'll leave you to it, Willy. Have a good day. And obviously we can't really pick anything up here because we've got full inventory for now. Only Elliot's friends can enter uninvited. Wait, does he just give you a key when you're a good friend? I suppose, you know, that's maybe not unrealistic, but it is. He said it's where he lives. He's very well kempt for someone who lived there. Can we interact with these gravestones? Our beloved Mona. Oh, that's quite sad. I'll try and sneak out through the bushes. But no dice. We went to the sun house already. I wonder what we should do. We could start off by... Oh, we could explore up here. I was going to say we could clear out our farm a bit more, but let's have another look around. Here's Haley again. We've already spoken to her. Doesn't look like she has anything more to say. Well, this looks like somewhere we could clear out. Yeah. Fantastic. It didn't seem to do anything, but it was very satisfying. The community hall open now? Oh, it's still locked. It looks like the time's wrong as well. I wonder if that clock's just broken. Nice climbing wall. Little playground for the kids. Let's have a peek on the map. There is stuff further up. There's this big... It looks like a lumber mill or something up here. And something over here. Here is obviously the mines that we'd heard about. Carpenter's shop. Well, we went to the carpenter's shop. Here's the path in. I guess it comes down here and the bus comes down to there. Okay. All good stuff. We explore over this way. It's only 3 p.m. We've got plenty of time. We've watered our parsnips for the day. So let's have a wander around, see if we can find anything new. Go back into town. Did we go into this house? I think we did, and oh, it was locked, wasn't it? Oh, hello. George.
It's irritating to have to meet all these new people, huh?
I don't mind meeting new people.
Name's George, by the way. Now, buzz off. Huh.
Oh, he's in a wheelchair. Oh, well, we'll leave him be. He's obviously busy watching his shows. We can't go in this chap's room, I suspect. Not good enough friends with Alex to enter his bedroom. Probably for the best, because he's getting his lift on and he's... You know, you don't want people to watch you while you're working out. Dog! Doesn't look like there's a dog around. Bit weird. Anyone in here? Nope. Still looks to be empty to me. like a kid squad.
Oh, a stranger. My name's Vincent. Mama says not to talk to strangers, but you seem okay. Vincent.
You missed the point. You can't just judge the stranger person by person. Like, they might seem okay. I am actually perfectly fine. I'm not going to do any harm. But, apparently he's content to talk to us. Jazz?
Hi.
Okay, she's not going to say anything else. And then Penny.
I'm tutoring Vincent and Jazz today. They're a handful, but it's nice to make a difference in someone's life.
That's very nice of you, Penny. She's their tutor. Talk to this dude here. Come on. Oh, I wasn't clicking him.
Hey, I'm Sam. Good to meet you.
Hi, Sam. Nice to meet you too. Doesn't look like he has anything else to say to us today. I wonder if Elliot's got anything new on him. A great idea can pass through your head when you least expect it. But if your mind is too busy, you might miss it. Well, I really must get back to my work. What is it you do, Elliot? You live in a house on the beach? It's all a bit weird to me. But, each to their own, I suppose. Right, well, oh crikey, there's a real gathering over here.
This town's safe, but I always walk the children home anyway.
That's probably wise. Okay, that's all she's got to say for now. Right, well, we'll head over this way. Didn't see what was down here. Oh, some cows. Cinder Sap Forest, Pelican Town. I wonder who lives in this little house. Only Leah's friends can enter uninvited, so Leah's not there right now. This goes all the way over here. A real adventure you could go on. And we are, in fact, going on that adventure right now. Have a look at the map, see if... Doesn't really say where we're headed, to be honest. Looks like it's just a dead end. Ooh. Hello. Hello, hello, hello. Another mystery. It's locked. Oh, we can't get down there. But, there we go. So another locked area. Another possible mystery for the future. So yeah, I've heard this game is packed with little nuggets of intrigue and stuff to find and little stories to develop over time. So maybe we'll take another look at it going forward, but I wanted to get in here and show you the basics of tending to parsnips, wandering the town. And if you're interested, maybe I'll do something else on it down the line. Kind of a just sort of disheveled, rundown house here. Take a wander back over here. And we'll start to head up back towards the farm, because it's getting a bit late. It's very peaceful, though. Well, these woods are a little bit dingy. I suppose we could probably cut our way through them if we wanted to. Ooh, a clearing. Oh, and a little tower. You can hear someone inside. Can we knock on the door? Doesn't seem to do anything. Bizarre. Clearly another mystery to be solved. It is getting late though. I'd better start thinking about swinging back towards... Oh, we're not too far from the farm. This looks like a potential fishing spot. Although, who knows if they'd actually be able to catch anything there. Another signpost. Farm. I like how it just says farm. I suppose we are the only farm in town by the sounds of things. And here we are, back on our farm, although might have to carve our way back through. actually get up to, oh, there we go. You can kind of just walk through this, brush. Right, we've actually got quite a sizable chunk of land, really, when you look at it. But I think we're almost back up to the top now. Here we are. Here's our stuff. And the weather forecast was completely wrong last time. Let's try it again, though. Welcome to Kozu 5, your number one source for weather, news and entertainment. And now the weather forecast. Going to rain all day tomorrow. Well, you said that yesterday and it didn't rain once. So I'm not sure I trust you. Oh! We earned 20 gold from selling that one clay. That's all we've earned today. But we made 20 gold. That's better than no gold, I suppose. And now it's the third. Third of spring is a really weird way of phrasing it. I suppose that's just the game's mechanics. Sounds like it's raining, though. Ah, there we go. It is raining today. So I shouldn't need to water my plants. They can kind of get on with their own thing. So we'll be able to go on adventures. But I think we'll wrap up this first one today. I just wanted to have a quick look at the game and see how it played out. A little bit of a spooky noise. But, there we are. That's Stardew Valley. And again, it's kind of got traits of Harvest Moon, traits of Animal Crossing, but it's also got its own kind of personality to it as well. So plenty of stuff to explore. Looks like another building maybe we can reconstruct down the line. It's now in ruins. Well, maybe we should have come back a little bit sooner than the number of years we waited, but not really our fault. You know, we followed the instructions our grandpa gave us. And now we've got this farm to look after. And I'm quite excited about it. So, I think we'll wrap things up there. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this. If you have, be sure to bop that like button. And, you know, feel free to subscribe to the channel for more. Or, you know, just pop back whenever. There'll be plenty of other content from me, other games and such. If you want to see more Stardew Valley, do let me know in the comments. If you're enjoying this game, let me know what you're thinking of it. Because I'd love to hear from you, I'd love to have a chat about it. And, yeah, that's going to bring an end to things. So, thanks very much for watching. We'll talk to this one last chap first. Shane.
This weather makes me thirsty.
What, the rain? Just open your mouth. Pouring from the sky, mate. Alright, thank you for watching. I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers!